Hello everyone, I'm John Sharp, National Power Solutions Manager for Generac, and I'm here to guide you through another informative Power Design Pro Precision series. Before we dive into this video tour of PDP buttons, tabs, and navigation, remember to subscribe and hit the notification bell to be updated to the latest Generac design engineering videos. Now let's explore Power Design Pro's capabilities. I'm here at the dashboard after being logged in, and you'll see that there's a list of projects that I've been working on as well as ones that have been shared with me. I'm gonna go ahead and select this one. This takes me to the project solution screen, right, where you can see the different solutions that have been created for this particular project, as well as ATS and generator design bid specifications that have been produced based on the solutions. We're gonna go into a project that has already been developed here. Be able to show you the tabs. Up top here, we have the ability to edit this information, so you have the contact information. You also have the ability to delete this particular solution. You also have the ability to go back to your homepage. Okay. Also, you have the ability here to download a summary report, right? So once you've created a solution, you want to be able to download that in a PDF or a paper document. You'll be able to do that with this tab. Here you can edit the solution, right? So you could edit this solution and make some changes to it. You can also duplicate this solution. So if a customer is saying, hey, this is my day one solution and this is my year three solution, you can say, hey, this is what it looks like in day one, and we can add additional loads to maybe see what's the best overall project solution for the project. Again, deleting this solution or closing out and getting back to your homepage. Okay. Lastly, I want to show this particular button up here. This is the share button. For those of you that don't use Power Design Pro every day, maybe you need some assistance in sending this project to someone like a Power Design Pro professional or Power Solutions Manager like myself. We'd be able to help guide you through this by seeing the data that you put in and then help you produce a better solution. Here on the screen, you're going to see these are the limits that were set up when you had the initial project set up. And over here to the other side, this is where you're going to see the solution that was created and how you performed against those limits, right? So we say in this particular project, I had a load running KW of this, well, 49% of the capability of this project. Pretty self-explanatory from there. We also have additional tabs here to show you. We have a documentation tab. Once you've created a solution, we'd be able to download the documentation spec sheets for the product, as well as PDFs of layouts, right, for an open unit, level one, level two, different enclosures in both PDF documents as well as DWG if you want to import those into AutoCAD and work on those. If this is a gas solution, this is a tab that allows you to help figure out what is the gas piping design that you're going to need that's adequate to supply fuel for the unit. If the unit is going to need exhaust pipe extension, being it in the building and running out of the building or out of a building and running up the side, this is what we would use to be able to make those determinations to ultimately tell you what size pipe you're looking for. Transient analysis. This particular solution will be able to then tell you what was my worst load, right? What did I put in here and what drove the solution? And maybe I can make changes to that load to drive a smaller generator if that is your goal. Lastly, we have a tab on harmonic analysis. Harmonic analysis is just talking about nonlinear loads and how they impact the generator. This particular solution, we didn't put any loads in there that were nonlinear, so we have a nice smooth sine wave, not an issue there. Okay, getting back to the load screen here, you can see that this is a pretty functional area. There's all new presentations that are being put out about how you can add loads and create new solutions. And there you have it. A detailed look at some of the features within Power Design Pro. These tools are here to accurately design the solution and easily and effectively. And I hope that this tutorial has helped you harness the full potential of Power Design Pro. If you find this video useful, don't forget to give us a thumbs up and share your thoughts in the comments. Stay tuned for upcoming videos where we'll explore even more aspects of Power Design Pro. Until then, this is John Sharp, National Power Solutions Manager for Generac.